Welcome back, friends. After a half day tour of Gaul, I am on my way to Colombo. Today is Sunday. Hope trains won't be crowded. This is something interesting. Train timetable of good old days. I think I have seen this earlier in Kandy also. Part of history. So here is my train to Colombo at 2:46 p.m. Some express train written in Sinhalese. I came here expecting 1 o'clock train. This train will take 2.5 hours to reach Colombo. Hopefully, if I reach Colombo fourth station by 5:30 in the evening, I'll be able to visit some places in Colombo city. This is the last leg of my Sri Lanka trip. Gaul to Colombo by train. Same plus fare is 240 Lankan rupees. This time it is a steam engine releasing thick black smoke and polluting the air of this beautiful country. As the train first approaching towards Colombo, I realized my incredible Sri Lanka trip is coming to an end. The rewind of last 7 days took me back to the places I have left behind. 1 week's time just passed by in this country. Who are new to the channel can have a look at my journey. You can watch the other videos of my channel, Woods, Webs, Wings, and yes, don't forget to subscribe and share with your family and friends. Reached Colombo 4th station around 5:30 in the evening. That's the Colombo Lotus Tower. Colombo theke Rambekona jawar shomoye dekhechilam train theke. Back to the same spot where I started the Sri Lankan train journey. I can remember I was standing there 1 week back, with lots of excitement and inhibitions of a first time solo traveler. Now it's time to board a tuk-tuk and explore Colombo city on a Sunday evening. First I'll go to Independence Square. Roads are wide and not much traffic on Sunday. Colombo's skyline is changing. Construction are going on. Many high rises are getting built. In a few more years' time, a new port city adjacent to Colombo will be ready reclaiming land from the ocean. Nilampokuna Mahinda Rajapakse Theatre is a performing arts center. The architecture of the building is inspired by a lotus. the left side, that white color old colonial style building is a shopping mall, arcade. This whole area is known as Independence Square. It is the venue for religious events and annual National Day celebrations. Visitors can walk around the structure or relax. Local people of different ages spend time here in the evening, especially kids and the aged. Upper part of this monument is the Independence Memorial Hall. Independence Memorial Museum is at the basement of the Independence Memorial Hall. Museum is closed now. Independence Memorial Hall is a national monument in Sri Lanka, built for commemoration of the independence of Sri Lanka from the British rule in 1948. There is a statue of the first Prime Minister of Sri Lanka, John Stephen Senanayake, at the front of the memorial. After visiting the Independence Square, I reach Simamalaka Temple on the Beira Lake near Colombo City Center Mall. Simamalaka is a Buddhist temple and part of the Gangaramaya Temple. Entrance fee for this temple is 300 Lankan rupees or 120 Indian rupees. Same entry ticket can be used to visit Gangaramaya Temple, which is situated few hundred meters away. This temple is just opposite to the Colombo City Center Mall. There is another building coming up. In the evening, this place looks nice with all these lights and the lake. Picture quality is not good. I am using my mobile to take videos since all the memory cards are full now. This temple is mainly used for meditation and rest, rather than the worship. My next stop is Gangaramaya Temple. Gangaramaya Temple is one of the most important temples in Colombo. The temple's architecture is a mix of Sri Lankan, Thai, Indian, and Chinese architectures. These are some of the pictures I have taken this evening. And my Sri Lanka trip as a solo traveler comes to an end. What a journey it was. I enjoyed it thoroughly, every moment of it. It was a bit hectic to cover 6-7 places in a week, but totally worth it. Thank you, Sri Lanka. Beautiful country, wonderful people, amazing places. I have a very good experience here as a traveler. Thank you very much. I have shared my experiences through travel videos, what I have been through, what I have seen, what I have felt. Those who have watched my Sri Lanka travel videos, hope you have enjoyed it also. I am totally new to blogging and video editing, learning about this so that I can present my travel stories in a better way in future. Please do subscribe to my channel Woods, Webs, Wings and share my travel videos to your family and friends. This is very much required to grow my channel. I'll be soon back with more travel videos from different parts of India. Keep watching, keep traveling.